Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Holly. Today I'm going to be planning the week of Valentine's Day in my B6 inserts. I'm going to be using this kit from Simply Watercolor Co. So gorgeous. I just don't know what to do because I have this like gorgeous bottom washi that I kind of want to bring in. So we might just try to figure out a way to make that work on this page. I don't know. I guess I could always just use the like I love you still part. Anyway, we're gonna figure it out. But so this kit does look like it has rose gold foil, but I find the Simply Watercolor Co. rose gold foil can read kind of goldish. And honestly, I have like all my gold foil stuff out anyways, and I kind of like gold with this kit better than rose gold. So we're gonna do kind of like a mixed metals thing, you know? We're gonna keep it interesting. So I'm gonna go ahead and dive in. Okay guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and start out with the to-do headers at the top. They are very faint, but I can see them in real life, and that is what matters. I did decide to do my to-dos at the top this week. I just decided that might be a little bit more functional now that I am doing to-dos in this planner. I kind of don't like having them at the bottom sometimes because it's hard to like write on, especially in a traveler's notebook where you're like kind of writing in it more on the go. So I am cutting down the checklist in this kit to just be 4 hearts. I didn't really need all 6 for most days of the week. You will see on the weekend, I'm going to use all 6. Last weekend on Sunday, I used everything. And then on Saturday, I used nothing because I totally ignored my planner that day. But it was good to have the space there. So I'm going to put these. And I did like kind of a pattern on the other days. And then on the weekend, I wanted it to match. So I just used this 2 of the same color because I just thought that looked nicer. And here I'm putting my full boxes down. I'm trying to figure out like what I want on the weekend. I wanted some pretty ones, but I also didn't want to use 2 foiled ones because I was like, I need to save some because there's 4 foiled boxes and 4 unfoiled boxes. So you're going to see a lot of indecision with the full boxes in just a sec, but I did put that gorgeous quote box in the top left. And like I mentioned, I think in the intro, I am using like these are rose gold foiled boxes, but I'm going to probably use some gold, not probably, I'm going to use some gold foil in the actual spread as you will see in a moment. And I decided to skip the headers for the full boxes. It just takes up extra room, and the full boxes in this spread really are just decorative. I think I put something in a full box like one day, but everywhere else it was just kind of decorative. So just trying to get the spacing right. I really like Jessenia's idea in her B6. I forget if it was like this week or last week, but she had ordered a horizontal kit. I am totally going to steal that and try that out because smaller full boxes would be amazing because I feel like there is like limited space in here, so it'd be really nice to still have decorative full boxes but keep them smaller. Then I am using these foiled headers that came with the mini kit. They're just too pretty not to use, but I didn't use them on the weekend because I already had like less space there because I was doing 6 hearts, but I decided to squeeze them in during the week. And now I'm going to go ahead and do the sidebar. So there's 1 habit tracker in the kit. Like I said last week, that's like my meta habit tracker to make sure I do my habits in the like habit tracker insert I have. And then I'm just using the extra decorative headers to divide up the sections, kind of just like foiled washi. Then I am using the this week with the weekly ombre for my dinners for the week. And then for the bottom, I'm taking some of the leftover piece of bottom washi that's in the kit, and then just kind of using that as a background for some deco, just to fill in that space a little bit because I don't really need to use that space for anything else. And then I decided I did want to do date covers. So I had these gorgeous ones that were kind of Valentine's themed from Simply Watercolor Co. as well. I was really torn on where to put the numbers for these. I need to watch other people's plan with these because I know some of my friends use them. I'm curious like what other people did. Like I didn't know if I should put the numbers in the heart. I felt like in person, like the foil was getting really, like you can even kind of see it there. Like if I put it on top of the foil, the transparent numbers, it kind of blocked out the foil, which I didn't like as much. So I just kept changing it up, and now it just looks really strange that everything's so different. But the date covers themselves were gorgeous. I really, really loved those. I just could not figure out what I wanted to do. And then on to Monday, I wanted to mark down a friend's birthday. So that little present is from a $2 Tuesday sheet from Simply Watercolor Co. And then I'm also grabbing a little kind of script birthday word from a Rose Colored Days sheet. I've been having trouble with some of those script words. They're just like a little sticky on the cuts, but it's fine. But I just like, you probably just saw me struggling there. And then for the quarter box, I wanted to note down going for a run. So I took a Simply Watercolor Co. foiled running sticker. And then for Happy
happy hour I had that night, I took a girl's night sticker from my collab sheet with Simply Watercolor Co. or from one of my collab sheets. And then I was trying to figure out how to kind of squeeze in. I had like a bunch of bills due and videos and things like that this week. And I decided to use that space at the bottom again this week for the actual Clever Gal Crafts hearts, which is what that pink heart is. It does cut into the space a little bit, but it's fine. And then these little arrows are from My Newest Addiction. So I just kind of put all the other little random little things like the bills and the YouTube videos down for the rest of the week. And I don't know. It was kind of like... Yeah, I didn't love the way it looked, but it was functional. Like I said, I'm just kind of playing around with everything that can fit in these inserts and how I want to make them the most usable. And then on to Tuesday, I am taking the laptop to Markdown working from home. And that laptop is from Magic Prints Co. And then I am borrowing some leftovers from my Two Little Bees kit. That is the flag. And that appointment sticker is from a sheet from Planning World because I wanted to mark down that I had a dentist appointment. And then that night, going to Elevate like normal. So I'm taking a gym day flag from one of my collab sheets with Simply Watercolor Co. They're on like the nude background, so they look nice with this kit because like the quote box is a nude background, some of the headers and stuff. So it worked really well. And like I said, those are gold foil. Some of the kits rose gold. It's fine. We're making it happen. And then on to Wednesday, I took a transparent holiday sticker from Rose Colored Days that says Happy Valentine's Day and just layered that over the full box. I love being able to do that with transparent foiled stickers. I think it looks so cute. And then I wanted to mark down just celebrating Valentine's that night with my husband. First I am marking down friends' birthdays. I'm that bow. Washi box is from Simply Watercolor Co. And the happy birthday is from Rose Colored Days once again. I had two friends with birthdays on Valentine's Day. There was my face. Sorry about that. And then on Wednesday, I just wanted to mark down going to Starbucks in the morning for a little treat. Then I took a little Clever Gal Crafts meal icon from, it was like an older Valentine's sheet that she did to mark down that my husband was cooking dinner on Wednesday. But I'm actually going to move that because I was like, wanted to add another sticker I discovered. And then I also just put like another little icon from the Clever Gal Crafts sheet because I couldn't find like a baking sticker that would fit in that space to mark down that I was going to bake cookies. So here I'm kind of fussing with things. The sticker I'm trying to get in is the little paper princess plans princess, paper princess plans princess, to mark down. Just like I wanted to use those characters. She's holding chocolates and wine. And I just thought that was perfect for Valentine's night. Then on to Thursday, I am going to lift, or I already did lift. So I put a kettlebell from the collab sheet with Simply Watercolor Co. at the top of a half box. Then I put a don't forget sticker for something that I am literally currently forgetting. The irony is not lost on me. And then I took a Magic Prints Co. trash can to just mark down trash day, obviously. And then on to Friday, I used that meal sticker that I had pulled up before and another paper princess girl to mark down going out after work. And then I just took a flag for a reminder for myself. And then on to Saturday and Sunday, I'm going to work out both days. So I took a workout flag for an Elevate class on Saturday. That is from my Simply Watercolor Co. collab. And then on Saturday, I'm also putting down a little planner from Simply Watercolor Co., a little traveler's notebook to mark down planning and filming. And then on Sunday, I'm also adding in a bill due because I didn't have space for it in the bottom because I already had the video there. Again, those little arrow things are from My Newest Addiction. And then I wasn't quite sure about my plans on Sunday, so I left that box blank, but I filled it in now. And now I'm just kind of filling in other stuff. I'm using that checklist. This kit comes with one checklist and one weekly ombre because it's the mini kit. So I used for the checklist just to mark out my Instagram posts for the week like I would normally use a weekly ombre. And then I did put in some of the bottom washi, the I Love You Still, I thought could kind of look cute on its own, and I just thought it was too pretty not to use. And now I'm cutting down some also to just kind of use as regular washi to fill up the rest of that note section since I don't really use that. And now I'm adding in, of course, all this gorgeous foil deco everywhere. If it has foil on it, you can't let it go to the leftovers drawer. That's just like cruel and unusual punishment. And I'm also using some of these little Clever Gal Crafts icons because I just thought they were kind of cute and added some extra Valentine's Day theme. So that is pretty much it for this spread. I hope you guys enjoyed it. enjoyed it, make sure to like and subscribe if you did. And yeah, that is it. Hope you guys had a good holiday week. Not really holiday, but anyways, thanks for watching. Talk to you soon. Bye.